Hey friends, welcome to my channel Dental Edge. My name is Dr. Bhanuja. First of all, a very happy new year to all of you. I hope you all must have made your new year resolution, and I also made mine. Mine this year's new year resolution is to make more and more dental videos that are much more easy to understand, and I'll make more such videos. For example, videos that will help you to do time management while you're studying for your BDS or your MDS, and how to deal with the stress and everything. So do subscribe to my channel and keep watching. Today I'll be talking about odonto. It's an important topic since it's asked in examination as a short note, or it's also kept in the practical examination for identification as a slide. Then there can be many viva questions from the same. Also, there are many MCQs, fill up the blanks, that are asked from odonto. So do watch the video till the end. Now, as you can see on the screen, odonto, if you divide this word into two parts, it's odont, which means something that is of odontogenic origin, and oma. Oma means a benign tumor. So it's, by definition, it means a tumor of odontogenic origin. Now, you should always remember the classification of odontogenic tumor. This classification is asked in examination as a part of long answer, and if you remember the classification, you will remember many other things. For example, in the classification of odontogenic tumors, as you can see it on the screen, the odontogenic tumors, they are divided into three categories depending on the tissue of origin. First category is tumors that are that originate from the odontogenic epithelium. The second is tumors that are derived from the odontogenic epithelium plus odontogenic ectomesenchyme with or without hard tissue formation. And third category, it is tumors that are derived from the odontogenic ectomesenchyme. Now, if you remember this classification on the screen, you will remember that odonto, it falls in the second category, that is tumors that are derived from the odontogenic epithelium as well as ectomesenchyme. There are many authorities who believe that odonto is not a true neoplasm, although it's an hamartoma. Now, for that, you should know what's a hamartoma, right? So, hamartoma, if I explain you it in simple words, you can see on the screen as well. Hamartoma, it's a disorganized mass that is native to the place. Then it has limited growth potential and it does not recur. So the odonto also, they just grow to a certain size and they do not recur. So they have limited growth potential and they are native to the cells of origin. So many authorities, they believe that it's not an odontogenic neoplasm, although it's a hamartoma. Now, coming to the definition of odontum, I'll read it word by word for you to understand. A growth in which both the epithelium and the mesenchymal cells, they completely differentiate. That is, they will form ameloblast, functional ameloblast, and functional odontoblast. Right? So, as you can see, with the result that functional ameloblast and odontoblast form enamel and dentin. So, functional cells are formed. So, hard tissue formation is there. The enamel and dentin, they are usually laid down in an abnormal pattern because the organization of the odontogenic cells failed to reach a normal state of morphodifferentiation. So, to explain you, it's a growth in which both the epithelial and mesenchymal cells, they differentiate completely to form functional ameloblast and functional odontoblast, and they also lay down hard tissue. But this hard tissue is laid down in an abnormal pattern, in a haphazard pattern. And you can relate it with the traffic jam, it's haphazard, or you can also remember your lockdown utensils. So, hard tissue formation is there, but it's in an abnormal pattern. It's not arranged properly, right? One more thing you need to know is odontum, they are the most common odontogenic tumors or odontogenic tumor like lesion. Now, odontum, it's a mixed tumor. Why it is a mixed tumor? If you know the definition of a mixed tumor, a tumor that arises from more than one type of tissue. So, odontum, it is deriving from more than one type of tissue. That's why it's a mixed tumor. One very important viva question for odontome is it's called a composite odontome. Why is it called a composite odontome? Because composite means something that is consists of several parts, many parts. So since there is presence of enamel, dentine, cementum, you know, hard tissues, so it is called as composite odontome. So further, odontome, that is a composite odontome, is divided into compound composite odontome and complex composite odontome. Now let's see what's a compound composite odontome. A compound odontome is when the hard tissue, that is the enamel dentine, it is laid down in such a fashion that it has some resemblance to normal teeth, although it is much smaller than the normal teeth in size. Complex odontome is when the dental tissue, it is just an irregular mass, disorganized mass with no anatomic similarity even to rudimentary teeth. Now compound odontome, it is more common than the complex odontome, remember this. So odontome are of two types, compound and complex. Compound odontome is when the dental hard tissue, it has some morphologic similarity to rudimentary teeth, and when this mass has no similarity, anatomic similarity to rudimentary teeth, it's called as a complex odontome. Compound odontome, they are much smaller than the normal teeth. And compound odontome, it is more common than the complex odontome. Now coming to the etiology, it is thought that odontome, they are derived from the extraneous bud of the dental lamina. The exact cause of its origin is not known. It can be due to local trauma. Don't go with this image, it's just for you to remember it. This is not the only kind of local trauma. So there can be any kind of local trauma, or it can be due to some kind of infection or some genetic mutation or interference in the genes involved with the formation of teeth. Now coming to the clinical features of odontome, whenever you think about clinical features, you should understand that clinical features, it means that how it appears clinically, in which age you will see this tumor, or at which site you will see it, or at in which sex it is more commonly seen, how will it appear in the patient. So coming to odontome, it is can be seen in any age, but it is usually seen in young people. So second decade of life is the most common age, and 14.8 years is the mean age of occurrence for odontome. So young individuals it is usually seen. Then coming to the sex predilection, it is almost equal in both males and females, but certain studies, they believe that it is slightly more common in males than in females. Coming to the site of occurrence for odontome, now remember that odontome, it is more commonly seen in maxilla than the mandible. The compound type of odontome, that is the one that has some resemblance, anatomic resemblance to rudimentary teeth, that is more commonly seen in maxilla, and that too in the anterior maxilla, that is in the incisor canine region. The complex odontome, which is the less common type, it is which has no resemblance to even rudimentary teeth, it's just a disorganized mass, that is more commonly seen in the mandible, and in mandible also it is seen in the posterior area. Also both types of odontome, they are more commonly seen on the right side of the jaw. Now odontome, they are usually asymptomatic, and the patient, you may see it incidentally on a radiograph, or a patient will come with a complaint of an unerupted tooth, permanent tooth, or a retained deciduous tooth. That is when you will maybe take a radiograph and see the presence of an odontome. They are usually symptomatic. But sometimes the features that we, clinical features that we present is an unerupted permanent tooth, retained deciduous tooth. There may also be, if it grows in size, for example, a complex odontome, then there may be presence of infection or swelling around it. That can also be present. And usually odontome, they are smaller in size. Sometimes they erupt also, and rarely it may grow to a size that may lead to facial symmetry. It is not very commonly seen. Coming to the radiographic features of odontome, it is characteristic, and as a dentist, since it is diagnosed accidentally, so you should know how an odontome looks on a radiograph. Now it is usually situated between the roots of the tooth, or sometimes, for example, in complex odontome, it may be present above an unerupted permanent tooth. If we see the compound odontome, they appear as a cluster of teeth. Now this can be a few in number or many more in number with the same peripheral outline. Now, coming to the radiographic features of the complex odontome, it will appear as a heart tissue mass, disorganized heart tissue mass with a radiolucent band around it and a smooth peripheral outline. Both of these, complex and compound odontome, they are usually associated with an unerupted tooth. In the first image, you can see a cluster of tooth-like structures. It's a compound odontome that is not allowing the eruption of a maxillary canine. In the image seen below it, you can again see a large cluster of tooth-like structures that are not allowing the eruption of the mandibular canine. In the other image that you can see on the complex odontome, it appears like a cauliflower or a disorganized mass that is not allowing the eruption of the molar. So there is a retained molar in that image because of the overlying odontome, complex odontome. So, coming to the histopathologic features of odontome, there is presence of dental hard tissue, that is enamel or enamel matrix, pulp, cementum, dentine, which may or may not exhibit normal relationship to one another. If morphologic resemblance to teeth exist, then too these are usually single rooted. There is presence of a connective tissue capsule around the odontome, and this is similar to the dental follicles seen around normal teeth. Now, the compound odontome, as I told you, it will have some resemblance to rudimentary teeth. So, it recapitulates to some extent the morphology of normal tooth. So, they are denticles, that is small tooth-like structures in a fibrous connective tissue, and around that there is presence of a connective tissue capsule. If you can see this image, enamel or the enamel space is present, then dentine-like structure is present, then odontoplastic layer is present, the center some pulpal tissue is also present. These are the single denticles that are present in connective tissue. So it shows some orderly arrangement of the dental heart tissue, that's why it's a compound odontome. Now the complex odontome, it appears as a disorganized mass of heart tissue. If you see this image, there is presence of enamel space, then there is dentine, there is cementum, there is some pulp present, but they don't have an organized manner. One more thing that you need to know is, and I'll show you, that in complex odontome, a radial pattern of heart tissue is seen. That is, the pulp shows small branches that extend within the tissue and it gives a sponge-like appearance to it. This is a feature that is seen in complex odontome. To this case, in which the clinically we see there is a retained deciduous tooth, and this is the complaint with which the patient came, and then when the radiograph was taken, as you can appreciate, there is a presence of many small tooth-like structures surrounded by a common radiolucent band. That's a compound odontome radiographically, and it is not allowing the eruption of the permanent central incisor. This is how the clinical finding with the patient may come with. Another image, there is presence of tooth-like structures in the radiograph. And if you see macroscopically, that is when the odontome was removed from the oral cavity, these are small single rooted tooth-like heart tissue structures, which are typically smaller than a normal teeth. One more additional interesting feature that can be seen in odontome is the presence of ghost cells. Ghost cells, these are cells that are seen in, for example, in COC, and according to some studies, only 20% of cases of odontome, these show presence of ghost cells. And there is no significance to their presence in odontome. Coming to the treatment of odontome, surgical enucleation, that is, you have to completely remove it, and there is no chance of recurrence for an odontome. So we are done with the topic. Thank you so much for watching the video. Do let me know in the comment box your feedback, as well as if there's any other topic that you want to read. Also, it takes lots of effort to make such videos. Your one like can give me lots of encouragement to make more such videos. So do like, subscribe, and share. Thank you.